Well, good morning, church family. It is Wednesday, April the 8th, and I am honored to be here with you again this morning, praying for you today, missing you like every day, and I hope that today you see God move in a really neat way in your family and in your situation. That's what I'm praying for you. Before we get into our devotion this morning, I want to remind you of this coming Sunday. Sunday is Resurrection Day. Sunday is Easter Sunday, and we are so excited about Easter Sunday. The unfortunately part is that we can't meet together. We can't celebrate our risen Savior together. We can like this, we can in our homes, we can where we are, but we can't celebrate it together as one body. And so I want to encourage you to join us. If you are not watching anything online, or if you don't have a church home or anything like that, I don't know, just join us online at 10 a.m. on Sunday morning as we celebrate our risen Savior. You can go to fbfirst.com. That's fbfirst, spell it out, .com, and click on the live link there on our website, and you can watch live. Or you can go to Facebook and find us on Facebook, First Baptist Church, Fernandina Beach, and we will be streaming live. It's going to be a great, great Sunday morning. So just wanted to remind you guys of that. Let's get into today's text. For last four devotions, we've kind of looked at the characteristics of God, and as we're looking at all the do not be afraid, fear not type of things that we see in the scriptures, phrases that we see in the scriptures that I believe that depicts a characteristic of God. Today what we're going to look at still comes out of the book of Joshua, and it's actually four of these verses. I'm going to read them all to you and then just tell you what, I don't know if it's a characteristic of God, but it's more of an action of God, of who He is and what He does. And so I hope this little truth today hits home with you. And just to be honest with you, it is more of an offensive type of characteristic. It's more of a, you know, for the last few times we've seen Don't Be Afraid, it's been more of God is our protector, He is our provider, and He does, and He is everywhere, and it's great. But today is more of an offensive thing. I don't know why, but today I just feel like it's time we understand what God is doing kind of behind the scenes of what we don't see. And so that's where these verses are from. So if you have your Bible, or if you just it comes out of Joshua like we did the last couple days, Joshua chapter 8 verse 1, Joshua chapter 10 verses 8, Joshua chapter 10 verse 25, and Joshua 11 verse 6. And so I'm going to read these verses to you, and then I'm going to tell you the underlining truth for today, okay? Joshua chapter 8 verse 1. And the Lord said to Joshua, "Do not fear," there's a phrase, "and do not be dismayed. Take all the fighting men with you and arise, go to Ai. See, I have given into your hand the king of Ai and his people, his city, and his land." Joshua chapter 10 verses 8. And the Lord said to Joshua, "Do not fear them, for I have given them into your hands. Not a man of them shall stand before you." Joshua chapter 10 verse 25. And then Joshua said this to his people, to his men. He said, "And Joshua said to his men, do not be afraid or dismayed. Be strong and courageous, for thus the Lord will do to all of your enemies against whom you will fight." Basically, he just beat an army, and so he's saying this is what the Lord's going to do for all the people that we fight. So that's what that one's about. And then Joshua 11 verse 6. And the Lord said to Joshua, "Do not be afraid of them, for tomorrow at this time, I will give over all of them slain to Israel. You shall hamstring their horses and burn their chariots with fire." Now, that sounds really kind of violent, and it sounds really harsh. But the truth of the matter is Israel at this time, they were going into the promised land, and they were taking the promised land that, like we talked about yesterday, everywhere that Joshua and they put their feet, the God was giving them that land everywhere they trod because he was already there. Now, the truth of today's scripture is this, is that God fought these battles for Joshua and the Israelites. And the truth for us today is this, is God is fighting your battles for you. God is behind the scenes doing things that you and I do not know, and we don't understand, and we don't see. But God is fighting those battles. God is taking our situation, and he is fighting the battles. We're to do what we're supposed to do. Joshua still had to do what he had to do. But God is doing what he and only he can do. Maybe in the hearts of men, maybe protecting doctors, nurses, maybe doing something bigger. And this week, the Holy Week, leading up to the resurrection, I believe God is fighting our battles and bringing people to him. And in your situation, what you cannot see, God is fighting your battles for you. I want to read a couple more scriptures that kind of have to do with this, don't be afraid or things like that, but it has to do with these. And it says, Exodus 14:14 says, the Lord will fight for you. You have only to be silent. And then in 2 Chronicles 20:17, it says, you will not need to fight this battle. Stand firm, hold your position, and see that the salvation of the Lord on your behalf, O Judah and Jerusalem. Do not be afraid and do not be dismayed. Tomorrow you will go out against them, and the Lord will be with you. And then in Deuteronomy, it says, 20 verse 4 says, for the Lord your God is he who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies, to give you the victory. And then the last one, Deuteronomy 3:22 says, you shall not fear them, for it is the Lord your God who fights for you. And that's my prayer for you today, is to understand that God, no matter what your circumstances is, and sometimes we don't see it and we don't understand it, but God is fighting for you. He loves you. God is fighting for you. So today what I want to do is I want to be thankful. I want to be thankful for you, church family. Not being able to see you, not being able to be with you, give you a hug, shake your hand, a high five, whatever. I just miss you, and I am very thankful for you. I'm thankful that we have a church family. And if you're seeing this online and you do not have and you're not a part of a church family, I want to encourage you to find a church family. But anyway, thank you. I'm very thankful today for my church family. And then today also, what I want us to do is I want us to pray for our government officials, for our leadership, for the president, for the leadership in the White House, for the leadership in your certain cities, your mayors, your governors. Doesn't matter if you agree with them or not, we're praying for wisdom for them, asking God to fight that battle and give them wisdom, because they need it right now. So that's what we're going to pray for. So please join me in prayer. God, I just want to thank you for your son Jesus and the grace and mercy that comes through him. God, my prayer is that, Father, that today we that are here, our church family, God, that we sit back and realize that you are fighting our battles for us, no matter what kind of situation we're in. It may seem bleak, but God, you are fighting our battles for us. And so I pray, God, that we can see that and see what you're doing and see your hand at work. And God, I just want to thank you for my church family. God, I just love them, and I pray for them right now, and I lift them up to you. And I just want to pray that maybe there's someone out here that does not have a church family. God, be with them. And Lord, also, God, I want to pray for our leadership, our government leadership. Lord, whether we like them or not, God, number one, I think you've commanded us to pray for them. But God, I just want to pray for their wisdom. I pray you give them wisdom, Lord, from our national leadership to our local leadership. God, even to the leadership in the homes, in our homes, Lord. That's specific. God, I just pray, Lord, that you would give all of us wisdom during this time.
Lord, we love you. Can't wait for a day to be together with the church family again, worshiping you. But God, we just thank you for who you are and what you're doing, and that you are fighting our battles for us. We love you, Jesus, in Christ's name. Amen. Well, guys, once again, thank you for being here, praying. Remember, praying for you, but remember to turn down the media, turn down the volume of the media, and turn up the truth of God's Word. And in Christ, there is hope. And I pray that you have hope today and realize that God is fighting those battles for you. Hope, have a great day. See you tomorrow.